Welcome. I am the creator of a game called Money Dash. In this video, I will show you how to create a Sprite Atlas, how to make it work properly, and why you need it. In this test, we can see in the stats tab that we have 25 matches on our game. Every match represents an individual sprite that is drawn and a draw call that is sent to the GPU. This causes a huge drop on our frames per second. Let's see how this happened in the frame debugger. To access the frame debugger, open the window menu, analysis, frame debugger. Here, we analyze every batch and we see how it is drawn our frame, step by step. We can reduce our batches, putting all our sprites in the same sprite atlas. Let's create our new sprite atlas. Sprites, we will create a sprite atlas just for that. We just drag our folder into the objects for packing list and click on pack preview. Here we have our sprite atlas that is nothing more than a big image with all our sprites inside. We can see that there is two pages on it. Every batch only can draw images that are on the same page of a sprite atlas. To fix this, let's increase the max texture size of our atlas. Now, we have all our layers in the same page of our sprite atlas. Next, let's create a sprite atlas for our character. See, our character atlas have more than 50 pages, so let's increase to maximum our max texture size. We could also reduce the import size of our images, or just make smaller atlases of my character sprites. Now, my atlas have just 4 pages. That should be good enough. On this test, we have reduced our batches from 25 to 13. It could not be huge for you now, but if I had 100 characters on the scene, I would save 1,200 batches. This could be 600 frames per second more. If you found this video helpful, consider to subscribe and like, so you help others to find it.